Hey guys, if you're looking for a video on how to upgrade to Windows 10 from Windows 7, 8 or 8.1 for free, then this video will definitely be of interest to you. With this method, you can even get the Windows 10 free download media and run it without having a previous version of Windows, albeit with a few caveats. In this video, I'm going to show you how to upgrade Windows 7 to Windows 10 for free. Or if you prefer, how you can get the Windows 10 free download media to allow you to install Windows 10 from USB or DVD, which you can then install onto multiple computers. So 32-bit versus 64-bit. Isn't 64-bit just twice as fast as 32-bit? Without getting too technical, the short answer is no. 33-bit is twice as fast as 32-bit. And 34-bit is twice as fast as 33-bit, and so on. 32-bit and 64-bit are worlds apart where speed is concerned. The question is, do you have the application which will benefit from 64-bit? But to be honest, 64-bit is now considered the norm, so if you can, go for the Windows 10 64-bit download. Here's a table to show the architectures. If you upgrade any 32-bit version of Windows, after the upgrade, you will get the Windows 10 32-bit download. Likewise, if you upgrade from any 64-bit version of Windows, you will get the Windows 10 64-bit download. If, however, you want to upgrade from a 32-bit version of Windows to the Windows 10 64-bit download, please understand that simply upgrading will not work. You must perform a clean install, and this means that you may lose your data. Regardless of whether you upgrade or install a fresh copy, please, please, please do a backup first, in case anything goes wrong. You shouldn't lose any data with the upgrade, but it's best to be on the safe side of caution. It's not only the architectures which matters, but also the addition of Windows. If you are upgrading from Windows 7 Starter, Windows Home Basic, Windows Home Premium, Windows 8, or Windows 8.1, you will get the Windows 10 Home download. If you are upgrading from Windows 7 Ultimate, Windows 7 Professional, Windows 8 Professional, or Windows 8.1 Professional, you will get the Windows 10 Pro download. Right, enough of talking about the theory. Time to get on with the Windows 10 upgrade. I guess it goes without saying, but I'll say it anyway. You must log on as a user who has local administrator rights. Otherwise, it will fail. If you don't already know, it will probably be a good idea for you to identify which version of Windows you are currently using. To do this, open the System Control Panel. This can be done by either clicking on the Start, Control Panel, System and Security, and System. Or you can use the keyboard shortcut, which is the Windows key, together with the pause break key. Here you can see that I'm running Windows 7 Professional and I have 4 GB of memory installed. Notice that the architecture I'm using is 64-bit. This means that after the upgrade, I will have the professional version of the Windows 10 64-bit download. As I've already said, choosing the Windows 10 upgrade route will not change the architecture from 32-bit to 64-bit. And if I scroll down, we can see that this version of Windows 7 is activated, and this is the product ID. Now, before anyone scrambles for a pen, notice I said the product ID. This is not the product activation key. This key will not activate any copy of Windows 7, 8, 8.1 or 10, because this is not actually a key. It is information which shows a Windows technician exactly what version of build of Windows you are using. Before you start the Windows 10 upgrade, my advice is to make sure the page file is optimal. Otherwise, you may be waiting for a long time just because of the way the memory is allocated. It's easy to do and it can save you hours. To check the page file, click on Advanced System Settings, click on the Settings button, select the Advanced tab, and then click on the Change button. As you can see, Windows is recommending that I have a 6 GB page file. but the system has only allocated 4 GB. As a guide, I turn off the automatically managed paging file and switch to custom size, and hard set this to 2x the installed memory. To calculate this figure, open the Windows calculator. So 1 GB is 1024 megabytes. Multiplied by the 4 GB I have installed, which gives us this figure in megabytes. Now just simply multiply this by 2. And this is the figure I use to set my page file. I set the initial box and the maximum box and then click set. Click OK to that, and if it prompts you to restart, do so before you proceed. Right, let's log on to this computer again. Now you need to turn off Windows Defender, otherwise the download will take days because every single file is scanned and then rescanned. To do this, click on the start and just type services and select the services icon, which stops and starts Windows services. Scroll down to Windows Defender, and if it's not disabled, double click on it. Change the startup type to disabled and then stop the service. And then click apply and OK, and it should be listed disabled. You can close the services window now. Using your internet browser, navigate to this page. I'll add the URL link in the description below. Click Download Tool now and save the Media Creation Tool to download Windows 10. Open the location to where you saved the Windows 10 Media Creation Tool and run it. You can close the browser now, as you won't need that again. For long pauses, I have sped up the video and added a timer to give you an idea of how long the processes take. You should read the license terms and then click Accept to proceed with the Windows 10 free download. Personally, I haven't managed to get the Upgrade This PC Now option to work. It just hangs, and 24 hours later, I have to cancel it. So I'm going to choose the Windows 10 ISO download, so I can create Windows 10 bootable USB or DVD media, which you can then use to upgrade other computers if you need to, without going through the long download again. Set your language and edition of Windows, and if you're likely to upgrade both 32-bit and 64-bit computers, it might be worth you choosing both architectures, but I just want the 64-bit, and then click Next. Now you're prompted to confirm this is the correct version of Windows to match your license key. Because I only had Windows 10 as an option, I'll just click OK. I'm going to choose the ISO file so I can write it to either DVD or USB, and then click Next, and this will ask for a file name to give the download. I've previously downloaded this, so I'll just overwrite that and keep the file name the same, and then click Save. The Windows 10 free download will now begin. As an idea of how long this may take, I'm downloading with a 300 megabit internet connection. Once the Windows 10 ISO download has finished downloading, you'll need to burn it to DVD or use a third-party program to create Windows 10 bootable USB drive. If you don't know how to make a bootable USB Windows 10 drive, I'd recommend Rufus, which is totally free. Using your browser, navigate to their website and download the latest version. I'll add the URL in the description below. It's a single file which does not need to be installed, just run it. The device should automatically default to your USB drive. To ensure you are using the correct drive for the Windows 10 ISO, I suggest you remove all other USB drives. It may squeeze onto a 4 GB USB drive, but I would recommend at least 8 GB. Please note that all data on the USB drive will be erased. You don't need to change any of the default settings, Just point it to start your Windows 10 ISO download by clicking the image icon and select the file and then just click start. Once you have the Windows 10 ISO download image on the USB drive or DVD, insert the DVD or USB drive and click Run Setup on the pop-up window and then click Yes. Some of you may have an antivirus program running or something which prevents the auto-run from starting this pop-up. If you don't see the pop-up, open the file via the Windows Explorer and then double-click Setup.exe and you'll end up with this screen. As you can see, the first screen you're prompted with is asking if you want to download and install the latest Windows 10 update. I do not recommend this because if it hangs, you'll have no idea why. Let's just focus on how to install Windows 10 and then let Windows 10 update itself in the background. So click Not at the moment, then click Next. Have a quick read of the license terms, and when you're ready, click Accept. In this instance, the drivers for my adapter do not meet the minimum Windows 10 system requirements, so it's flagging me with an error. This should be fixed once the Windows 10 update is completed in the background. So I'll click on Confirm and then OK to acknowledge the error. Now the update process will check the computer has enough disk space to accommodate the Windows 10 update. Here you can decide what files to keep. I'll leave this as the default, which is to keep everything. This means that my existing files shouldn't be affected, but common sense says to make a backup before you start this. And 52 minutes later, my Windows 10 free upgrade is complete. Welcome to Windows 10, and click Next. Now you'll be presented with the much talked about Windows 10 privacy settings. I'm sure you'll have your own opinion on this, but I'm going to just turn off everything. Although I may need to enable the Windows 10 update feature. I'll also click Use Cortana, then click Next. Now Windows is finalizing. Now I can log on. Notice my display is still weird with these thick black lines either side. I'll fix this once I'm logged on. As I log on, the new Windows 10 builds my profile and starts to apply any updates it's been made aware of in the short time it's been active. I'll close the Microsoft Edge browser, which is replacing the deprecating Microsoft Internet Explorer. To fix my display, I right-click on the desktop and choose Display Settings. And here in the Resolution option is a list of all available resolutions. For this demonstration, I'll just select 1280 by 720, and that's it. Hope you enjoy your new free Windows 10 upgrade.